Hello everyone, I am Sanita Rawar, Assistant Professor, School of Pharmacy, Suresh Gyan Vihar University, Jaipur. So today is our next lecture on industrial sterilization on large scale. So we will start with the basic introduction of sterilization. So as you know, what is sterilization? We have already covered in our previous lecture that sterilization can be defined as any process that if we effectively kills or eliminate the transmissible agent like fungi, bacteria, virus from a surface, equipment, foods, medication or any biological culture medium. So today's lecture is all about your industrial sterilization on large scale. And so learning objective of today's lecture is you are able to know, we will study about the basic sterilization, to study about importance of sterilization and the various type of sterilization and the process that are used in the deployment and the validation of the equipment that are used in sterilization. Now, learning outcome of today's lecture, you are able to know about the sterilization, importance of sterilization in industry, various method of sterilization used in large scale and equipment used in pharmaceutical industries for sterilization. Okay, so we will start with basic introduction of sterilization. What is sterilization? Why we need sterilization? So if we talk in the general term, sterilization is basically to remove any unwanted thing or the microbial agent that contaminate our product, our final product, by using different method. So basically sterilization is the process of killing or removing the microbial or any fungi, bacteria or living organism collectively to protect our product from contamination or from spoilage. That process is called sterilization, and we use various kind of machineries, various kind of instrument to remove that contaminated things. Okay, so sterilization can be defined as the process through which all forms of life are destroyed, removed or permanently inactivated. So if we talk about what are the form of life that contaminate our product, so we have a virus, fungi, bacteria, worms and many other life bacterias, those who can contaminate our final product. So sterilization is essential concept at large scale as well as small scale for the preparation of sterilized pharmaceutical product. So as you can know, if in our daily life, okay, we have eat food, okay, and the food we eat, we wants to eat a particular good food, the food is very like healthy and not contaminated by any bacteria. If we take our food for one day, okay, so the bacterias grow in it is spoiled as such, because we take it in open area and we take it like it is very easy for bacteria to grow in the food. And as same as that in pharmaceutical industries, where we are making lots of medicine in different doses form, like in syrup, tablet, vials and tubes, various material, okay, so we have to free our pharmaceutical products from contamination. So that's why we are using the sterilization techniques, because if any living organism is contaminating our final product, so it can be spoiled and we do not have a good product and it will not give a better result to the patient. That's why we have to sterilize everything in every step. Now, its aim to provide a product that is safe and eliminates the possibility of contamination. Why we use sterilization? to reduce amount of contaminants present in the environment on surface or counters, closures, as well as equipment and adhesive better sterilized condition. Okay, so from manufacturing to the final good, from raw material to the final product, for the from the packaging also, every step of making a manufacturing a product, a pharmaceutical product, we have to follow the sterilization process so that our product will be very good and good to use, and it will give a very good result. So what are the sources? First we have to see the sources where the where our product can be contaminated, so that we can sterilize everything. Okay, so when we see from the starting to the end point and the final good product, we follow, we see where can our product may be contaminated. Okay, so the first thing, raw materials, where from we are making our product. So the raw materials that are maybe in the crude form, in the powdered form, and the various other forms. So it can be, it came from there. The equipment and the instruments we are using to make our product, and the manufacturing process that we are following to make any pharmaceutical product. Then the containers and the closure system, the container and closure where we are like packing our or indulging our product. Then the manufacturing environment where it's manufacturing, the people out there, the worker that are working in that areas, in that people who are involved in the manufacturing of the product. Then the sterilization process. What is the sterilization process? How many types of sterilization process we have? So basically we follow two kinds of sterilization process. The first one is physical method and the second one is chemical method. Okay, then we have categorized physical method and chemical method in their subcategories. Like, we will start with the physical method. So physical method we have categorized in moist heat physical method and dry heat physical method. If we talk about the moist heat physical method, we find out it is a saturated steam autoclave, it is a superheated water autoclave, and it is a air oven steam autoclave. So we have categorized physical method into two categories: moist heat method, dry heat method. Then we have categorized moist heat into the further three types. The first one is saturated steam autoclave, superheated water autoclave, air oven steam autoclave. Then the next category we have dry heat. Okay, so dry heat is continuous tunnel sterilizer. The second one is hot air oven. Then the red heat and the flaming. So in and the physical method we have categorized the second type, dry heat, and dry heat includes continuous tunnel sterilizer, hot air oven, red heat, and flaming. Then we have radiation method. So radiation method we use non-ionizing radiation, and the second one we use ionizing radiation. So non-ionizing radiation we have UV light, ultraviolet light, and then ionizing radiation we have cold sterilization. Cold sterilization include X-ray, gamma rays, and cathode rays. Now another method we have filtration method in physical method. Okay, so we have depth filter we use stained glass filter, and the second one we have a screen filter. And in screen filter we have two categories. The first one is particulate filter and the microbial filter. Now the another method we have chemical method. So chemical method is used by using some kind of chemicals for the sterilization process. So in chemical method we use gaseous method. So gaseous method include ethylene oxide and formaldehyde. by using disinfectant or antimicrobial agent. Okay, then the process of selection. How can we select that which kind of sterilization method we have to use for this product? So process selection is the most important and selective point for preparation of product. So those product intended to be sterilized should be terminally sterilized in their final container as clearly stated in the European Pharmacopoeia. Every product that will be final, that will start from the manufacturing to the final container, we have to sterilize it in every step. Only then the product will be marketed. So where it is not possible to carry out terminal sterilization, choose the alternative method. So we have to sterilize every pharmaceutical goods. We do not have to another options for the sterilization. We have to sterilize every process. It should be followed. Then it is recognized that new terminal sterilization process other than those described in the pharmacopoeia may be developed to provide sterility assurance label equivalent to the present official method, and such process when properly validated may offer alternative approaches. Okay, then the use of an appropriate heat label packaging material cannot in itself be the sole reason for the adoption of aseptic processing, and rather manufacturer should choose the best sterilization method achievable for a given formulation and select the packaging material accurately. Okay, so if we do not use the sterilization process according to the material, okay, so it can destroy by the process of sterilization, because the type of materials also depend upon the sterilization process. For example, if we are using a heat sensitive material, okay, and we are sterilizing it in the autoclave, so maybe it can cause a very harmful effect. It will deteriorate the pharmaceutical product. So we have to choose the packaging, choose the material, choose the sterilization technique according to our product. Now, the choice of packaging material for given product has to take into account factors other than the method of sterilization. In such cases, these other factors needed to be clearly documented, explained, and significantly justified. So, if we see in the flow chart, we have found process for aqueous substance. This is the sterilization process for the aqueous substance. If the product is aqueous, then what we have to do? How we have to sterilize the aqueous product? So, firstly, product can be sterilized by the moisture at 121 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes. Then it can the product be sterilized by the moisture? So we have to check it. So then we have to take it for 8 minutes, and then we can also use autoclaving at 121 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes. If we are using the moist heat process, can the formulation be filtered through a microbial reactive filter or the use of moist heat with 8 minutes, approximately 8 minutes. Okay, then the another thing is if the product is filtered through a microbial relative filter, so we have to go use pre-sterilized individual component and aseptic compounding filtering method. then we have to use combination of aseptic filtration and aseptic processing. So here we have two choice. We have to choose wisely according to the product. Next, if the product is non-aqueous, so the before that we have seen the process for the product in which is aqueous. Now, if the product is non-aqueous, semi-solid or dry powder, so how can we sterilize that? Can the product be sterilized by dry heat or at 160 degrees Celsius for 120 minutes? If yes, so then can the product sterilize by dry heat with the alternative combination of time and temperature so that the standard cycle achieving an SEL of more than 10? So if you then we have two choice, then use the sterilization at 160 degrees Celsius for 120 minutes. If yes or if not, then we have go for this. So can the product be sterilized by a method different from the dry heat, for example ionization? So if not, so we have to can the sterilization by the validated lower irradiation dose, then use a method different from the dry heat ionization. If not, then we have go for the different methods. If yes, so the can the formulation be filtered through a microbial relative filter or use the sterilized by validated lower irradiation dose? Then if yes, then use pre-sterilizer individual components and aseptic compounding and filtering. Then the another one is use filtration and aseptic techniques. If yes, then use filtration and aseptic techniques. So this is all about the flowchart of process of sterilization for aqueous and for non-aqueous or semi-solid or dry powder. Now we have a specification of moist heat sterilization. So microorganisms destroyed by cellular protein coagulation, the object to be sterilized are exposed to saturated steam under 1 atmospheric pressure at a room temperature of 121 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes. An autoclave is commonly used for moist heat sterilization, and because it does not require a high temperature, moist heat sterilization causes less product and equipment damage compared to the dry heat sterilization. So as compared to the heat sterilization, moist heat sterilization is better option for some product because it cannot damage the equipment and it cannot damage the product as well, because in the moist heat sterilization we are providing a moist temperature and in the heat sterilization we are increasing the higher temperature. Then autoclave, we have an autoclave. Autoclave is a device to sterilize equipment and supplies by subjecting them to high pressure standards. Like temperature, we have maintained 115 to 180 for IBS square per inch 10, and time we have to take it for 30 minutes. Then if so it is decrease. So we have to increase the temperature, and it is very opposite. Like if the time is increased, so temperature is decreased. Okay, and if the time is decreased, so temperature will be increased. Then the type is portable autoclave. We call it bench autoclave. Then we have the second type, secondary autoclave. That is mostly used in the small laboratories for small research work. And stationary autoclave is used in the large scale, like in industries and in the vital areas. So as you can see, this is your autoclave. Then the main features of autoclave is lid. The door is fitted with the clamps and absorb jacket. Stationary autoclave may be double doors at both end, or one for loading and one for unloading. Pressure gauge is also available there, and the thermocouple for the measurement of temperature, so then we can easily check the temperature. Then we have air vent to remove the air before sterilization. Safety valve to permit escape of excess steam to prevent the explosion. Then we have modern autoclave are recording record pressure, temperature during the whole process, supplied with the timer and the automatically controlled. Because nowadays there is a lots of invention into the autoclave, so that our product will be very fine, and the features like recording and the pressure, maintaining temperature, maintaining during the whole process is also now available, so that it can be easily monitored and it can be easily workable. Then the another method of sterilization is dry heat sterilization. So it is appropriate for materials that cannot withstand with moist heat sterilization, for example oily materials and the powders. So for oily materials and powders, we use dry heat sterilization. Objects are subjected to a temperature of at least 160 degree for 120 minutes, or if higher temperature can be used, lesser exposure time is required. So as I already told you, the temperature and the time is work oppositely. When we increase the temperature, we have to decrease the time, and when we have increased the time, we have to decrease the temperature. So for dry heat sterilization, it is also same. As you can see, is a device, a hot air oven is a device to sterilize subject and supplies by subjecting them to direct heat at temperature and time. You can see in your screen. So when we are maintaining the temperature 170 degree Celsius, so we have to take it for 60 minutes for sterilization. And the highest, when we are making the 140 degree temperature, degree Celsius temperature, the time limit, we have to take it for 180 minutes. Then it is appropriate for the materials that cannot withstand with the steam sterilization, like oily materials and the powder, and if higher temperature can be used, less exposure time is required for hot air oven sterilization. Now, as you can see, this is your hot air oven. This is the image of like a normal laboratory hot air oven, and this is the industry based hot air oven. So the main features of hot air oven include, it has door fitted with the clamps, and Abstox jacket has the single door, and it is regular for temperature control. It has a regulator for the temperature control, so we can easily maintain the temperature. And the fan is attached inside for the air circulation, and perforated shelf for the keeping subject inside. So it is very easy to use and control the temperature, regulate the temperature. Now we have another method of sterilization, that is radiation method. Now energy transmitted through the space is variety of forms is generally called as radiation. This method is also called as cold sterilization because it provides relatively very little heat as compared to the steam sterilization and then heat sterilization. So it required very low amount of heat, and thus it is possible to sterilize heat sensitive materials, such as techniques are being in food industries mainly. So for the materials that are very heat sensitive, that destroy in the presence of heat, that destroy while we are using the sterilization process of heat. So we can use those materials, those are heat sensitive, in the radiation for sterilization. Like in food industries, radiation technique is mainly applied for the sterilization of heat sensitive materials. And we have another method of radiation, non-ionizing radiation by UV method. So UV method is a region of 3237A has been shown to process the greatest activity in the destroying microorganisms. Commonly employed in reduction of airborne contamination, in the maintenance of aseptic areas and rooms. Source of artificial UV radiations is UV lamps, generally called sterilizing lamps or germicidal lamps. And UV light is absorbed by the nucleic acid of the cell, where it does the greatest damage. So the we can say the mechanism behind the sterilization by UV is it targets the nucleic acid of the microorganism of the cell of the microorganism, and it damages it and it kills it. So as you can see, this is your UV chamber, and the things, the heat sensitive things we are taking here for the sterilization purpose. Now, the another method is ionizing radiation, or we also called it cold sterilization. X-ray, gamma rays and cathode rays are the lethal to the DNA and other vital cells constituent. They have higher penetration power and considerably energy. The factor that affect the lethal activity of ionizing radiations are oxygen effect, productive compounds and sterilizing agent, pH of culture, freezing moisture and recovery conditions. So in cold sterilization, the mechanism behind the sterilization is they damage the DNA and another vital cell constituent of the microorganism while we take our product in the sterilization. Then the another method is filtration. So in filtration, this is a non-thermal method of sterilization used widely in the pharmaceutical industry, where heat labile solution are to be sterilized. Thus, it is useful for the large volume solution, eye drops, antibiotic solution, sera, carbohydrate solutions. So filtration method of sterilization basically used for eye drops and the large volume solutions, antibiotics, seras, carbohydrates. So this also useful for the separation of bacteriophages and bacterial toxins from the bacteria, from the isolation of microorganisms which are stenti in the fluid. Three main stages that are involved in the filtration method of sterilization are, first, it has to passes of the solution through a previously sterilized bacteria proof filter, UNITE, aseptic transferase of the filtrate to sterilize container then sealed aseptically, and testing of the sample for sterility testing. So these three methods involved in the filtration sterilization. Now, we have another method of sterilization, that is gaseous sterilization. Gaseous sterilization basically sterilized by using some gas. The destruction of all living microorganisms with chemical in the gaseous or vapor state. When material is affected by the dry or moist heat, then the gaseous sterilization is used. All these gases are toxic to human being above certain concentration and may exert or other undesirable side effects. So if these gases that are used for sterilization, they are toxic as well for human being, and in certain concentration, in we can say in higher concentration, and it can also give some undesirable side effects. Ethylene oxide is the most widely used gaseous sterilization agent in the pharmaceutical industry for gaseous sterilization, and in addition to those, various glycols, methyl bromide and alcohol have been used for the room sterilization. Then ethylene oxide, how ethylene oxide be used for the gaseous sterilization method. So it is colorless liquid with a boiling point 10.8 degrees Celsius, highly inflammable and may be explosive when mixed with the air in concentration greater than 3%, and its mixture with the CO2 in certain proportion make inflammable. And concentration and time relationship commonly for sterilization is as above. So if we see the concentration of the time for hours and exposure of the ethylene oxide, we have mentioned if we take it for 44 minutes, so the exposure time is 24. So as it is here mentioned. Then the disinfectant or antimicrobial agent, that are the another method used for sterilization. So chemical agent most commonly used as disinfectant, antiseptic, for example phenols, alcohol, halogens, dyes, aldehydes, etc. And phenyl and alcohol most commonly we also use to for in our day to day life for sterilization, like in our household, in the hospitals, in the companies, in the schools, to sterilize everything. Then development and validation process of equipment. How can we validate the equipment that we are using for like sterilization process? So there is a particular guideline for the validations for the equipment, like process validation. So it is analysis of data gathered throughout the design and manufacturing of the product in order to confirm that the process can reliably output products of determined standard, and it regularly authorized, like EMA and FDA have published guidelines regarding to the process validation. So we have to go through the guidelines to process the validation process. So the purpose of validation is to ensure or verified inputs lead to the constant and high quality outputs. Then process validation is an ongoing process that must be frequently adapted as manufacturing feedback is gathered. End-to-end validation and production is essential in determining product quality, because quality cannot always be determined by finished product inspection. Process validation can be broken into three types. The first one is process designing, process qualification, and continued process validation. So if we talk about the process designing, in this, data from the development phase are gathered and analyzed to define the commercial manufacturing process. The data used to establish benchmark for the quality and production control. Then coming to the process qualification, in this stage, the process design assists to conclude if the process is able to meet determined manufacturing target, and all the process and manufacturing equipment is proved to confirm quality and output capabilities. And then the last point is continued process validation. So in this, if it is the ongoing monitoring of all aseptic of production cycle, it aims to ensure that all label production are controlled and regulated. So we have to follow these three process for process validation of any step or any equipment. Then we have equipment validation qualification. So we have seen the process validation, and we have broke it into the three categories. The first one is process design, process qualification, control process validation. Now we have equipment validation qualification. So in this, equipment validation is divided into four categories. The first one is design qualification, then the installation qualification, operational qualification, and performance qualification. So for the equipment, we have to check out these things, like if the if our equipment is working or not working properly. The first one, we have to check the design and design qualification, how the design of our equipment it is, and then the installation, how it will install, and then the operational qualification, how it is operating, like the process behind it, and the performance, how it's giving the outcomes. So we have a design qualification. So DQ, it defined the functional and operational specification of the instrument and details for the continuous design in selection of supplier. Okay, so it is we checked the functional and operational specification in design qualification. Then in IQ, installation qualification, we demonstrate that the process or equipment meets all the satisfaction is intended correctly, and all the requirement components and documentation needed for the continued operation are installed and in the place. So we check it out. Then we have OQ, operational qualification. So in this, we have to demonstrate that all factors of the process or equipment are operating correctly or not. Then we have a performance qualification. So it is the process of demonstrating that an instrument constantly performed according to the specification appropriates for its routine work or not. So these are the equipment validations qualifications we have required for any our equipment whenever we are taking it by need or using it in our process of sterilization. So we first we have to validate the process, how the process we are going through, and then we have to validate the equipment validation also. Only then we are able to perform the sterilizations very easily. So today in today's lecture, we have studied about the sterilization, why sterilization is important, what are the method of sterilization, like physical method, chemical method. So in physical method, we have seen the thermal method, radiation method, and filtration method. And in chemical method, we have seen the gaseous method. In physical method, we have already studied about the heat sterilization, dry heat, moist heat, and then in the we have seen the moist heat like boiling water, and then we have seen the moist heat sterilization, hot air oven, autoclave. Then we have seen the radiation method by using UV, and then we have also seen laminar airflow chambers, filtration sterilization. And we have also discussed about the chemical sterilization method by using gaseous method, and we have also seen the importance of process validation so that everything goes smoothly. Then what are the use of sterilizations, and how it can use, who control it. Okay, so this is all about your sterilization. Now we have to we have some questions concluded for you regarding to this lecture. So the question included, what is sterilization? So it is very easy questions. I hope now you all get to know about the sterilization. What are the methods used for sterilization? then prenatal preparation can be sterilization through. So this is very simple question. What is the basic principle behind sterility testing? The absence of the form of microbial life, including pores, is known as which kind of sterilization? The three parameters of steam sterilization is, which method of sterilization is used to sterilize liquid? Factor for sterilization, proper plastic peel package should be placed, and a class 5 indicator is also called up, and the Bodick test is known as the. So if you go through the sterilization lecture, and if you go through these sterilization method, so you will get to know about the sterilization properly, and you are able to understand the sterilization properly. Now today's lecture references included the reference we have taken it with the sterilization.com, then we have taken some parts from the pharmaceutical microbiology by N.K. Jain, and the some slides are taken from the SlideSeers and SlideSeer of microbiology sterilization, and some of the contents are taken from the Precott L.M. Hartley by microbiology third edition, and then some are taken from the pharmaceutical microbiology Blackwell scientific publication, that is from the Oxford. So you can definitely check out these references also for the further knowledges. And I hope you understand about the sterilization. As you all know, sterilization is very important, and in our pharmaceutical industry, in our pharmaceutical process, sterilization play a very vital role, because if our product will be contaminated, okay, so it will not give the desired action, and it can also alter the pharmacological action of the drug, of the product that we are using to cure any disease. Okay, so or another thing, when we check out in our day-to-day life, so it is also important to be sterilize everything, because while the microorganisms are present in any our usable thing, or in the in medicine or in food, so they can contaminate and they can cause various kind of disease, so which are lethal to the people or lethal to the human. Okay, so this is all about the sterilization. And the another thing is, we also talk about the parental things for the contamination. So that is very important, because if we talk about parental, so parental also we directly take into the IM or IM and IV route. So it directly goes in the bloodstream. So if the product are not properly sterilized, so they can cause very severe side effect to the patient. So we have to check every particulate matter of the parenteral preparation, uniformity of the content, and sterility test, pyrosine test of the parenteral, check out the uniformity of the weight, clarity of the solution of the parenteral, and leakage also. So this is all about parenteral preparation. And one more thing, whenever we are going for the sterilization, we have to check out the product packaging also, because the packaging and the transportation also depend the sterilization. Okay, if we do not have packed our product very properly, so it will leak or it will contaminated by some other microorganism. So while we are making our pharmaceutical product, we have to check the packaging part also, because it is very important, and it is the final step also. thank you for today's lecture. I hope you will get all the knowledge about the you know about like sterilization, the process of sterilization, why we use sterilization, what are the equipment that are used in the large scale sterilization. Thank you so much for thank you for patiently listening to me.